Multiply the rational expression. Problem number 3. In this problem, we are multiplying 3 expressions. So to be able to do that, we have to first factor each part of the expression. Let's start up here with x squared minus 16. This would be factoring the difference of two squares, and you write your two sets of parentheses, square root the first term, which is an x and an x. You need a plus and a minus, and the square root of 16 is 4 and 4. Okay, now the bottom, 3x plus 21, I see that both of these terms share a greatest common factor of 3. So I'm pulling out a 3, and taking out a 3 from both terms, I'm left with x plus 7. Now, 12x is already in factored form. I cannot really factor it any further. And then the bottom, 5x plus 20, I also see a greatest common factor of 5. So taking out the 5, I'm left with x plus 4. And my last expression, x plus 7, is already in factored form, but x squared minus 4x has a common factor of x. So taking out 1x, I'm left with x minus 4. Now I'm ready to cross out all the common factors from top and bottom. So starting here, I got a x plus 4, and in the bottom an x plus 4, on top x minus 4, and in the bottom x minus 4, I have x plus 7, and x plus 7 in the bottom, and I have an x on top and an x in the bottom, and also 3 and 12 share a common factor of 3, so 3 goes into 12 4 times, and 3 goes into 3 1 time. Now I simplified everything I could, and I am going to rewrite the leftover numbers after multiplying them together. So on top, the only thing I have left is 4, and in the bottom, the only thing I have left is 1 times 5, which is 5. So the solution of this rational expression actually comes out to be a fraction without variables, 4 over 5.